What's up, YouTube? On this episode, we are talking about building the going out shirt. So this shirt is brand new. This is one of my shirts, and I built it kind of with a unique occasion in mind, or more of a general occasion, and that is going out. So for instance, date night or to a bar, something at night generally, and something semi-dressy, but not when I'd be wearing a necktie, for instance. So to do that, as a general rule of thumb, you tend to want to wear darker colors at nighttime. And so you'll reserve kind of the lighter tones and hues for things during the day. But at night, jackets tend to get darker, suits tend to get darker, and dress shirts can, not always. But my intention with this one was to have kind of a darker shirt, but not like a black dress shirt, because black dress shirts, unfortunately, don't stay black for very long. They start to fade pretty quickly and kind of look pretty poor in a hurry. So this is kind of a little bit more of a charcoal type take, and I'll give you a little close up here just to give you an idea that there are unique fabrics out there that are not typically what you'd expect in terms of a dark color. This has kind of like a little white pin dot. You can't quite see it in the video, unfortunately. You can kind of see the overall pattern, but up close in person, there is some very strong, but very subtle from a distance, very small little white pinpricks almost. And the buttons, of course, kind of match nicely. They are, see if we can kind of focus here. They're a little glossy, kind of interesting finish to them, but they are still plastic, so nothing too fancy. They're a synthetic, but they really tie everything together really nicely. And then, as we often do, we have a little bit of a contrast color, but this one isn't too bold or flashy. It's not like a bright red or something that's a real true contrast. It's much more something that will kind of be subtle and just reinforce the overall look, I think. But one thing that I don't usually do in my dress shirts, and this is the first one actually that I can even remember with a Bespoke Edge shirt, is I have a hidden button under the collar. Sometimes I've had a couple on the outside, and that makes for a very casual dress shirt. It's not something you're gonna really wear a tie with very often. I tend to do them in my summertime shirts. You've probably seen them quite often. But this one was for a particular reason, and that is that I will probably be wearing a suit or a sport coat at the very least when I'm wearing this dress shirt. And a common problem with me is that without having a tie on, which helps to cinch everything up, with no tie, the collar tips sometimes have a tendency to kind of come up and out and kind of conflict with the jacket lapel, at least for me anyway. So that's why I thought, well, if I'm always going to be open collar for the most part, let's do buttons underneath, kind of a hidden button-down collar, still get kind of a dressy look on the outside, but have that functionality of not letting my collar go awry and cause issues that, again, bother me personally. Okay, so zooming back out, the one final point I'll make is that this is indeed a French cuff dress shirt, and you'll notice that contrast that was up at the collar is also down here on the French cuff. And the way that we made this particular French cuff was to have kind of a cutaway so you can see that contrast. Now, again, if this was really bright, you probably wouldn't want to do it. Like a bright red, for instance, this is going to be really striking, very obvious. But again, this particular fabric just helps to reinforce the overall look and helps to kind of make the whole picture work really well. And of course, with those buttons, we have what I think is a really cool looking date night dress shirt. So there you have it. What are your guys' thoughts? When you are shopping for kind of a shirt to go out, are you usually reaching for something you currently have and might get a lot of use in the office, for instance? Or do you have kind of a go-to look or style that you like to wear? I'd love to hear it in the comments below. Sound off and don't forget to subscribe. We got many, many more videos coming. And we'll probably do some more on this one in particular and maybe make some comparisons on the different French cuff styles. So I think this one's kind of a good example of kind of a subtle approach on the French cuffs, but still getting that really elegant and sophisticated look as a general motif. All right, guys, thanks for your attention, and we'll see you soon.